Hi and welcome back. Today we're going to create a Happy Bee Day card. I'm using a digital stamp from Isabella Christina Stamps, and I hope I'm not butchering her name. She has a lot of beautiful digital stamps over at her Etsy shop, and I have been eyeing them out for quite some time, but now was the perfect opportunity for me to pick them up because she actually has a 20% discount if you are buying over 6 euro. So the first image here is actually a freebie that you can get if you click on over to her blog. But her images is always so beautiful, so go and check them out. I will have links down below. I'm organizing my images to print them out in my Word document, and I'm just changing the size of the paper to a letter size paper because that is the size I am using with my Nina 80-pound cardstock that I'm gonna print on. After I print them off on my home computer, I use my slimline dies from Trinity Stamps and cut this beautiful free image out. I started to color it. And here's a funny story. Up until this point, I actually thought I was creating a baby card. I thought it said happy baby. Why I thought that, I don't know. My mind is like so set on creating baby cards because I have so many in my nearest family that is getting babies. So I thought this was the perfect slimline image to create with, but I was so wrong. When I started to color the letters, I of course saw that it was Happy Bee Day, and that is of course very cute as well, but I was so set on a baby card, and that is why I chose all the colors that I did, because I needed a boy baby card. So anyway, funny story. This was so cute anyway, so I decided to keep going. And I used a white gel pen to emphasize some of the parts of the bunnies and the letters to make them pop a little bit more, and also cleaning off my edges. And after that, I will go in and create my background. Since this is a pretty flat card up until this point, I know I needed to create some dimension. And you can see this started to create some dimension, but then I looked at the picture that I got the inspiration to create from. You can see she has all of these beautiful dots in the background. Here's a close-up of that. So I was like, maybe I can mimic that in some way. So I looked at my stencils, and I have the perfect one from Trinity Stamps. This is the Slimline stencils, and they are 6x9. So without masking anything off, I just went in with my blending brushes from Trinity Stamps, with some light green and also some teal colors. This is a minty green, perfect for this scene, I think. And I am making sure that I'm not going over my images, but I wanted something in the background to make them stand out a little bit more. I had some spots that I wanted to go in a little bit more heavily, for example, between the bunnies there. And I also did some background colors with this green color, minty color. Then I took the larger dots in this stencil pack, and I will do the same thing but with the other color. And I think this was the perfect background for these cute bunnies, and I'm so happy she had done something similar because that got me the inspiration, basically. So super cute, and I love how this turned out. I also took a gray marker and went around my images just to create some shadows and to make the letters and the bunny stand out a little bit more against the background that we created now. So I'm just putting some more colors onto that, and then I will create my card base. So the thing I love with Trinity Stamps slimline dies is that if you take a standard Nina 110-pound cardstock, you can just basically cut it down to 7 inches and then score it at half at 3.5, and you have your card base. So you don't have to cut down more papers or use the whole thing, and then you can actually use the spare piece for the layering part. So that is something I absolutely love. I hope that makes sense. And I'm using the Big Mama foam roll tape from Simon's Stamp and just creating some dimension between my card panel and the card base. So now that we are finished with our card, pretty much, we're gonna embellish that a little bit with some sequins, and we're also gonna use some some I hate when I forget the name. Some of course, some shimmer, but also we're gonna go in with glossy accent. Glossy accent, it's called, on top of our banners, just to create a little bit more dimension. And that is something I also want to point out. This is a pretty flat car, and if you do a pretty flat car, I think it's good to have some type of dimension. Like for example, this glossy accent that creates a bit of texture to the card. The sequins create some texture, and also that we pop this up with some foam tape, the whole panel. That just makes this card look a little bit better in my mind than if it just had been totally flat. So that is something to have in mind. Now I'm going to use my big die cutting machine to fit all of these pieces out. This is the envelope builder die, also from Trinity Stamps. And I will score these, increase the score lines, and then we're going to put this together. And I'm going to use an adhesive that I wasn't happy with how this turned out, actually. I used a glue from Simon Says Stamp, and I haven't been using that glue enough to be friends with it, if that makes sense. So I didn't know how this was, that it was going to react the way it was. I have been liking it for my sequins because it has a small nozzle, but for this I didn't think it grabbed onto the texture of the paper enough. So I was actually switching the method of putting these together in a second here. I will use some strong score tape instead. If I had been smart, I would have done that in the first place, because I think that is a good adhesive as well. But you can see I'm trying to get the pieces on here. I'm needing to use something to make them grab onto the texture. So I tried adhesive on this flap as well, but I decided to take it away. You can see the darker parts there. It will not be visible in the end pictures, but at this point it wasn't totally dry. So for this flap, you can actually decide if you want it to the inside or the outside, but I want it to the outside. And of course, my last flap I will not adhere until I will send this envelope out. I have never sent it through the mail, but I have no reason to believe that it wouldn't work out fine. I don't know about postage, but it's different from the US and Sweden, so I will not go into that because I'm not an expert on that one. But I think it will go through the mail without any problem. And here you can see the dimension that the glossy accent created, and the sparkle, and also how well this fits inside of this envelope. So I hope you liked this project. If you did, please give it a thumb up. Don't forget to visit Isabella Christina Stamps if you want some beautiful digital stamps. And until next time, I hope you have a great day. Bye!